Hello everyone. Welcome to Learnaholic India. Today we are going to learn difference between DBMS and RDBMS. The topics that we are going to learn in today's session are: what is RDBMS? How RDBMS works? And DBMS versus RDBMS. So without wasting time, let's start with today's session. First we will see what is RDBMS. RDBMS stands for Relational Database Management Systems. All modern database management systems like SQL, MS SQL Server, IBM DB2, Oracle, MySQL and Microsoft Access are based on RDBMS. It is called Relational Database Management System, RDBMS, because it is based on relational model introduced by E.F. Codd. During 1970 to 1972, E.F. Codd published a paper to propose the use of relational database model. RDBMS is originally based on that E.F. Codd's relational model invention. Now let's see how RDBMS works. Data is represented in terms of tuples, rows in RDBMS. Relational database is most commonly used database. It contains number of tables and each table has its own primary key. Due to a collection of organized set of tables, data can be accessed easily in RDBMS. Now let's take a look at what is table. The RDBMS database uses tables to store data. A table is a collection of related data entries and contains rows and columns to store data. A table is the simplest example of data storage in RDBMS. Let's see the example of student table. It has 5 rows and 4 columns. What is field? Field is a smaller entity of the table which contains specific information about every record in the table. In the above example, the field in the student table consists of ID, name, age, course. Now let's see what is row or record. A row of a table is also called record. It contains the specific information of each individual entry in the table. It is a horizontal entity in the table. For example, the above table contains 5 records. Let's see one record, row, in the table. Next is what is column. A column is a vertical entity in the table which contains all information associated with a specific field in a table. For example, name is a column in the above table which contains all information about student's name. Null values. The null value of the table specifies that the field has been left blank during record creation. It is totally different from the value filled with zero or a field that contains space. Now let's see difference between DBMS and RDBMS. Although DBMS and RDBMS both are used to store information in physical database, but there are some remarkable differences between them. The main differences between DBMS and RDBMS are given below. DBMS applications store data as file, whereas RDBMS applications store data in a tabular form. In DBMS, data is generally stored in either a hierarchical form or a navigational form, whereas in RDBMS, the tables have an identifier called primary key and the data values are stored in the form of tables. Normalization is not present in DBMS, whereas normalization is present in RDBMS. DBMS does not apply any security with regards to data manipulation, whereas RDBMS defines the integrity constraint for the purpose of asset property. DBMS uses file system to store data, so there will be no relation between the tables, whereas in RDBMS, data values are stored in the form of tables, so a relationship between these data values will be stored in the form of a table as well. DBMS has to provide some uniform methods to access the stored information, whereas RDBMS system supports a tabular structure of the data and a relationship between them to access the stored information. DBMS does not support distributed database, whereas RDBMS supports distributed database. DBMS is meant to be for small organization and deal with small data, whereas RDBMS is designed to handle large amount of data. DBMS supports single user, whereas RDBMS supports multiple users. Examples of DBMS are file systems, XML, etc. Example of RDBMS are MySQL, PostgreSQL Server, Oracle, etc. After observing the differences between DBMS and RDBMS, you can say that RDBMS is an extension of DBMS. There are many software products in the market today who are compatible for both DBMS and RDBMS. Means today RDBMS application is DBMS application and vice versa. Thank you for watching today's session. If you are new to this channel, then subscribe to Learnaholic India and don't forget to click on the bell icon for the latest video updates. Give a big thumbs up if you like today's video, share this with your friends. If you have any query, then please comment below. That's it for today. Stay tuned for next video. Thank you.